Hi guys, it's Rahul here from Takeaway Pro, and Apple had just officially released iOS 18.1, and in this video we are going to learn what are the new features and changes that are coming up to your iPhone with iOS 18.1. So if you are going to upgrade to iOS 18.1, you need to see this video to know what are the new features that are coming up to your iPhones. The iPhones that are compatible with Apple Intelligence, as well as those iPhones which are not compatible with iOS 18.1. And by the way, iOS 18.1 has many nifty features coming up for both kinds of iPhones. Those iPhones that are not compatible with Apple Intelligence, as well as for those which are compatible with Apple Intelligence, like this one. So make sure you watch this video until the end to know what are the cool features coming up with iOS 18.1. Now, without any further delay, let's get started with the first feature that is coming up to iOS 18.1 on your iPhone. When you update to iOS 18.1, the first feature you will notice is the redesigned Siri. You can see this cool animation around the edges of your iPhone when you enable Siri, and Siri will listen to your voice and respond. And not only that, you can also enable Type to Siri and see this cool way how Siri responds to your queries. Let me show you this in action here. If I enable Siri and talk to Siri. Hey.
Hello, Tech Review. How can I help?
How is the weather today?
Expect partly cloudy skies today.
What will be weather tomorrow?
Expect some clear skies tomorrow.
Show me forecast of next 7 days.
Do you want me to use ChatGPT to answer that?
No, thank you.
I will not then.
As you can see, ChatGPT is completely integrated in Siri, and this is quite good. And similarly, you can also type to Siri and Siri will respond like this. Now, before I move on to the next Apple Intelligence feature of iOS 18.1, let me tell you, iOS 18.1, more precisely if I say iOS 18 is all about Apple Intelligence, and Apple is using Apple Intelligence as a branding material to sell its latest iPhones like iPhone 16 series. All of this year's iPhones that are iPhone 16 lineups are built from ground for the best use of Apple Intelligence features. But if you have got non-pro iPhone 15 models or earlier iPhones, you won't be able to access Apple Intelligence features on your iPhones. You will have to upgrade, and that's unfortunate. And not only that, Apple Intelligence also comes on iPad OS and macOS Sequoia as well. So if you have got one of these devices which are compatible with Apple Intelligence, you will be able to use Apple Intelligence features on your devices. Now let's move on to the next iOS 18.1 feature and changes, and it's about Apple Intelligence. You can see, if you go to settings, here you see Apple Intelligence and Siri, and you can enable and disable Apple Intelligence from here. If you have enabled Apple Intelligence, you'll get various Apple Intelligence features like writing tools and summary, etc., that utilizes Apple Intelligence to make best use of it. For example, if you open Safari and let's load any website, and if you open any article to read, you can utilize iOS 18.1 summary feature to summarize the text that you are reading. For that, you simply need to tap on this icon in the left side. And when you tap on that, it will show these options. So tap on Show Reader, and inside Reader, here you see Summary option. So if you tap on Summarize, here it will summarize the article and show you a summary of everything that is written in this article. So you can see it has summarized this article, and you can read a short summary of this article, which is quite good. And not only that, further you can also tap on this icon and make changes to the reader, like changing the background color, etc. And you can also utilize the listen to page option to listen to the text that is written. It will simply speak the
top 10 best white noise apps for Android and iPhone. Rahul Dubey Internet.
So it will basically read the text for you, and you can make use of text to speech feature on this Safari reader. Now let's move on to the third iOS 18.1 feature and changes, which is the biggest change of iOS 18.1, and more precisely if I say biggest change of iOS 18, which is writing tools. So ChatGPT is integrated everywhere with iOS 18.1, and you can make use of ChatGPT for writing and other things like summarizing, extracting key points, etc. For example, if I simply select the text from here, anything, you can see that the writing tools is integrated here. If I tap on it, here I get the writing tools options. So here is the selected text, and under that there are writing tools like proofread, rewrite, friendly, professional, concise, etc. So you can make use of these options like proofread, and this will proofread and make changes. Apart from that, you can also rewrite this. If you like it, you can copy it and paste in Notes and other writing apps as well. For example, you can see here I have got some text that I just copied from the website inside Notes app. And now if you select everything here, you can see there is writing tool here. And if you tap here, you can see writing tools here as well. So simply tap on writing tools and you get these options, and Apple Intelligence and Siri will rewrite this for you. If you like it, you can keep it or ask the Siri and Apple Intelligence to rewrite it and revert back to original as well. Apart from that, you can also play with other options like changing the tone to friendly or professional, and it'll make changes like that and rewrite for you. Once you are happy with that, tap done and you are ready to use this. And not only that, you can also use this writing tools in other applications like messages, pages, etc., wherever you can write. Now let's test it out in iMessage. So just open iMessage, and here if we just paste the text that we just copied, and after that we can rewrite this using this writing tool. As you can see, when I just selected the text here, here I got the writing tools option, as well as there is this icon here above keyboard integrated within it. So if you tap on it, here you get the writing tools, and you can use the same writing tools that I previously demonstrated and make use of these writing tools features in iMessage as well. Alright, apart from that, you can also make use of Apple Intelligence and Siri in the Mail app of iOS 18.1. So if you have updated to iOS 18.1, you will see this big change in the Mail app of your iPhone. If you just open Mail app and open any email, here you see the Summarize option, which is the Apple Intelligence and Siri exclusive feature. So you can tap on Summarize, and Apple Intelligence will summarize this email for you, and you can read the summary of this email. And this has done a pretty good job in summarizing this long email into this short one. Alright, now moving on to the next iOS 18.1 feature and changes, and you will notice that feature and change inside the same Mail app. For example, if you reply to any email by tapping on this reply icon, and after that tap on reply all, here it will show you suggestions for reply, and you can use Apple Intelligence features to draft a reply to this email like this. And further, you can utilize Apple Intelligence writing tools as well in case you don't like that. Pretty cool, right? Now let's move on to the next iOS 18.1 feature and changes, and that is coming up from the Photos app. If you just open Photos app on your iPhone, and let's open any photo, here you can see this new icon. If you tap on this, it'll show the lookup option inside Photos. So you can see it is selecting the object, and lookup is working right now. This lookup feature will recognize the object inside the photo. And when I tap on that, here you can see the results. That is, Siri is using the Apple Intelligence to show these options and various information regarding the object inside the image. And this happens quite fast. And not only that, you also get other features inside the Photos app with iOS 18.1. Like you can use the cleanup feature to remove any object. Let me show you that in action here. If I open this image and tap on this edit icon, here I get the option to clean up. So if I tap on clean up, Apple Intelligence and Siri will start suggesting you to clean up any object that you should clean from the image. Like you can see here, it is showing this recommendation, but if I want, I can choose any of other objects as well depending upon my needs. For example, let's suppose I want to remove this object from this image, so I'll simply drag my fingers onto this like this, and this will remove the object from this image. Let me show you another one. If I try to clean up this one, you can see that flower as well has been cleaned up and removed from the image. You can see some people here are being recommended to clean up using this cleanup feature, So I'll simply clean up like this, and this will be removed from the image, and it's working quite good. Once you are happy with your editing and cleaned up everything, tap on done, and this will save the edited image, or you may also tap on reset to move back to how it was previously, the original one. And apart from that, the Photos app on iOS 18.1 has also get a major upgrade, and that is allowing you to create memory inside Photos app. And Apple Intelligence and Siri uses its intelligence features to create a memory of photos inside your Photos app. But for some reasons, this is not working on my iPhone right now because I don't have enough images to create memory. But you can try that on your iPhone. Hope that would work for you. The next iOS 18.1 feature and changes is about call recording. With iOS 18.1 update, you get call recording functionality on your iPhones. And by the way, this iOS 18.1 call recording functionality is not only limited to Apple Intelligence compatible devices. And you can use this iOS 18.1 call recording functionality on any other iPhones that are launched after iPhone 10. More precisely, I would say iPhone XS, XS Max, and later on. Let me show you this in action here. As you can see, my phone is ringing right now, and you can see there is this icon as well for call recording. So I can simply accept the call, and after that I can tap on this icon and this will start recording the call. But before that, it will send the notification to both ends that this call will be recorded, and that is for legal purposes. So tap on this and this prompt will play in 1 second. And after that, both parties will hear that call will be recorded, and it also prompt you with notes for taking notes while on call. And once you have finished the call, you can end the call, and this entire call recording will be saved to your Notes app. You can simply open this, and after that you can play the recording. And if you tap on this icon, this will show the transcript as well. But this is not perfect, and sometimes it may not recognize the words correctly. And further, you also get the Apple Intelligence feature integrated in this as well. You can simply tap on summary and it'll summarize the call recording like this. But keep in mind, the iOS 18.1 call recording functionality is available for all iPhones after iPhone XS, but those iPhones which are not compatible with iOS 18.1 Apple Intelligence and Siri features will not get the functionality to summarize and transcript, etc. But you can still record on older iPhones like a normal audio file without any transcript and summary, etc. options that are integrated with Apple Intelligence and Siri features. And once done with recording, you may simply save this file to your Files app or share with other options as well. Simply long press on it, and after that you get the option to save audio to files or share audio with other options like these ones. Alright, now moving on to the next iOS 18.1 update and feature, and that is about the revamped notification center. If you expose this notification center like this, here you can see there is a number written next to the app and the notifications are summarized. You can see there is 3 written here. That means there are 3 messages from this app and all are categorized into just one. Similarly, you will see the number next to each app, and notifications are revamped in the iOS 18.1 update. And now that we are talking about notifications, let's talk about the next big change of iOS 18.1 update, and that is inside notifications. Here, a new focus has been introduced in iOS 18.1, and if you go to settings, then go to focus. Here you will see there is new focus, that is reduce interruptions. So you can simply tap on this and activate reduce interruptions in notifications, and this will use Siri to intelligently silence the unwanted notifications and interruptions while using this focus. And as always, you can allow people and apps to pass through this focus mode and allow notifications from those apps and people, and further add customizations as well and set a schedule as well. This will basically try to reduce interruptions while using your iPhone, and with smart Apple Intelligence and Siri functionality and technology, This will try to reduce interruptions while using your iPhone. Alright, the next iOS 18.1 feature and changes is from the control center. If you expose the control center, you can see here I have added mobile network and Bluetooth etc. That means you can add specific controls from the network settings now with iOS 18.1. Earlier you used to get only this option, which was entire network settings, but now with iOS 18.1 update, you get to choose various network icons inside from the network settings. Like you can see inside the controls here, under connectivity, earlier you used to get only option of adding connectivity controls, that is entire these options. Now you can add specific controls like Wi-Fi or anything else. So with iOS 18.1, the control center is becoming even better, and this is improving day by day. And not only that, further you can also reset the entire control center if you just messed it up. And that is our next iOS 18.1 big update and change. If you just go to settings and then scroll to control center, tap on it, and here you get the option to reset control center. And this is iOS 18.1 specific feature that you get to reset your control center. You can simply tap on reset control center and then confirm, and your entire control center is reset to the default one. So these are some of the cool iOS 18.1 features and changes that are coming to your iPhones. But obviously Apple Intelligence and Siri is the most talked feature of iOS 18.1 and something that every user is waiting for. And by the way, with the next iOS update, iOS is going to improve to the next level with various Apple Intelligence features like Genmoji and Image Playground that Apple has talked a lot in WWDC 2024. You can see Image Playground here on my iPhone. I'm testing it out, and I'll follow up with another video showing you all the cool features of Apple Intelligence that are coming to your iPhone. So make sure you subscribe and tap on the bell icon so that you don't miss any notifications about new videos.